We're going to determine the percent fat in potato chips. So we're going to start by taking a 100 milliliter beaker and recording its mass. So make sure you write down the mass of this 100 milliliter beaker. We're now going to take about 5 grams, and this mass doesn't have to be exact. We're going to use ruffles. And so we have our label, and this is a 42.5 gram package. We'll weigh out about 5 grams of chips. Okay, and again, we don't need this mass. We're going to get a mass of that more accurately and put our chips into our beaker, and we'll work on crushing these up. All right, now that they're all crushed up, we want to record the mass again, and it's important to do it at this point in case you lose any chips while you are crushing the chips. Okay, we are now going to add 10 milliliters of petroleum ether. Again, this volume doesn't have to be exact. I'm going to measure out about 10 milliliters and add it to the chips. We're going to mix this up for about 1 minute. And we're also going to set up our apparatus. So we're going to put a filter funnel. We're going to clamp this down to keep it secure. We're going to need a piece of filter paper in there, and we're going to hook this up to our vacuum system in order to pull that petroleum ether through the filter even faster. After this has been stirred for 1 minute, we're going to turn the vacuum on. We're going to pour our chips into our funnel here and try to get all of the chips in there. We're going to let that run for about 1 minute to pull as much of the petroleum ether out of the chips as possible. And we are going to repeat this particular step two more times. So we are going to dump these chips back into the beaker and then add more petroleum ether, mix it for a minute, and pull it through the vacuum again. All right, this is the second addition of the petroleum ether, and we're going to stir this for a minute again. Pouring the second addition of petroleum ether into our filter. And we're going to allow this to pull the vacuum again to draw that petroleum ether out for another minute. This is the last addition, the third addition of the petroleum ether. And again, we're going to mix for another minute. Filtering this for the last time for our ruffles. Once this has been filtered, we're going to make sure that we allow the vacuum to run for a minute to make sure all the petroleum ether has been removed, I'm going to place it back in to the beaker so that we can get a final weight of our potato chips. All right, we're going to get the final mass of our Ruffles potato chips. So this is after we have extracted all of the fat. We're going to start our second trial. We're going to weigh an empty 100 milliliter beaker so that we can do our second trial using Pringles. And so our serving size is 40 grams. We have our calories from fat and our percentage of fat for our Pringles. Again, we're going to weigh out about 5 grams. Of chips. And add them into our beaker to crush up. Here is our beaker with our crushed Pringles in it. We're going to follow the exact same procedure that we did with the first set, where we add the 10 milliliters of petroleum ether, mix it for a minute, filter it, and let the vacuum run for a minute. And we're going to do that 3 times in order to extract the fat from our Pringles. Here's the first addition of our petroleum ether to our Pringles. First filtration of our Pringles. Here is the second addition of our petroleum ether. Here is the second filtration of our Pringles. Third and final addition of petroleum ether. Final filtration. The final weighing of our Pringles. You should be able to use this data now to figure out the percent error of your fat found in your potato chips.